heading into the 2002 Olympic Winter Games in Salt Lake City, Russia was looking to extend its astonishing record in figure skating pairs. Since 1964, they'd been nothing short of dominant. Lyudmila Belousova and Oleg Protopopov set the precedent in Innsbruck, and 38 years later, the latest Russian pair was in the hunt for the country's 11th consecutive gold medal in the event. From the Soviet Union to the unified team to its current status as Russia, the powerhouse had maintained its firm grip on skating pairs. Going into the Salt Lake City Games in 2002, it looked like Russia's spell might finally be broken. Canada's Jamie Salle and David Peltier appeared to be the pair to beat. They'd won the World Championships in 2001, and their success was recognized as they were named as Canadian Athletes of the Year. Russia's Elena Baryshnaya and Anton Sikhorilidze appeared to be the biggest threat to the Canadians. They had a silver medal from the Nagano Games and had won World Championship titles in 1998 and 1999. Following the first two programs, they had a slight lead over the Canadians. Salle and Peltier had fallen during the closing pose of their short program, and they needed to score at least 5 5.9s in presentations on their free skate to win gold. The Russians took to the ice first. It was a beautiful performance, until Anton did this. Despite this, their scores were high enough to maintain first place in the standings. Next up was the Canadian duo.
Let's welcome now Jamie Salle and David Peltier,
who chose a simpler routine. They executed it flawlessly. They finished their performance to a roar from the crowd. It seemed the gold medal was in the bag. When the scores appeared, there was disbelief.
5-8, 5-9, 5-8, 5-9, 5-8, 5-9, and 5-9.
The Canadian pair's impeccable performance was only enough for the silver. Salle was distraught. The crowd echoed her feelings. 5 first-place votes had gone to Russia. There were just 4 for Canada. At the medal ceremony, Salle couldn't hide her disappointment. There was utter disbelief in Salt Lake City that night. Something didn't seem right. Back at the hotel that evening, the French judge, Marie-Lene Lagunia, was emotional. She spotted British official Sally-Ann Stapleford in the lobby and ran to her. Right then and there, Lagunia revealed the startling truth. The pressure had become too much for her. In front of witnesses, the French judge admitted, I was wrong. The Canadians were better. And confessed she was pressured by the French Federation and Didier Guillaguet to vote for the Russian pair in exchange for Russian voting for the French pair in ice dance. With this new revelation, Stapleford wrote a letter to ISU President Ottavio Cinquanta, explaining what she'd just been told. The wheels were in motion. An investigation confirmed the voting scandal. IOC President Jacques Roger announced to the world that there would be a joint gold medal for the Olympic ice skating pairs. On Sunday the 17th, less than a week after the contest, a second medal ceremony was held. This time with both the Russians and Canadians on the top podium. The scandal prompted a reform in the scoring system. The old 6.0 system was thrown out of the window and a new one was brought in. Judges' scores would become anonymous and only a subset would be used in the final judging process, meaning that a computer would randomly select scores from a certain number of judges. Marie-Reine Lagunier's confessions had changed the face of ice skating forever.